Do you know why you get up in the morning? Go to work, eat, sleep, repeat? In other words, do you have some sense of direction and purpose? If you can't answer that question with a loud and clear yes, don't worry. Most people don't know the answer either. But as a result, they return home from work feeling unfulfilled. On 28th of August 1963, Martin Luther King delivered a speech that made a huge impact. He gave a purpose to the American people to challenge the status quo and to make change, with the famous words, "I have a dream." Finding your why can be challenging, but once you have discovered it, you have defined purpose and determination. It is a strong emotional driver to feel a connection with a brand that is a progressive identity than buying from a generic company. This is the topic of today's 5-Minute Friday session, where I'll simplify the complexity of brand purpose, the why people should care about your brand. What's up, everybody? Arnt Eriksen here with yet another 5-Minute Friday. As always, do you A, have a tasty beverage available, B, a notepad to write down ideas and questions during this session, and C, mentally prepared for a few minutes of insight. Brilliant. Consider subscribing to this channel, give it a thumbs up or smash it if you so desire, and please leave a comment down below or talk to me on Twitter or Instagram. It is Arnt Eriksen everywhere. All right, here we go. Think about this question. Who are you and why should I care? It might seem odd or even rude depending on the situation, and still it is a question that truly will define what type of company you have or want to have. The fact is, we are being bombarded with thousands upon thousands of brand impressions each day. And for us to figure out which ones we decide to give our attention to is more and more limited and given to the selected few. Now, as an Apple fanboy, I can easily start off with their Think Different motto, because it perfectly describes their why. With everything we do, we aim to challenge the status quo. We aim to think different. How they do this? Our products are user-friendly, beautifully designed, and easy to use. So what do? We just happen to make great computers. Want to buy one? As brands strive for differentiation, relevance, and growth, a clear purpose brought to life in compelling ways is often the difference between success and failure. Let me explain. A major misconception is that purpose is solely about social good initiatives, or sustainability, or CSR, or cost marketing. All of these things can be outputs of a good brand purpose, but they are not by any means the only possible ones. A great purpose should manifest itself in everything your brand does, from product development to customer experience to how it conducts its marketing. Another misconception is that purpose cannot change with time, as well as that brands should only get involved in solving these massive problems of the world: social justice, climate change, inequality. Not true. Brands have the opportunity to solve problems from the everyday to the epic. Under Armour's purpose is to empower athletes everywhere. They are creating physical or digital experiences that are at the intersection of useful and delightful, adding value to people's lives, gaining a degree of loyalty that no TV ad can ever achieve. Which means that there are plenty of everyday pain points that a brand can invest its resources and energy in resolving. You might be a bit confused between some of the terms used, so let me spend a few moments to simplify the difference between purpose, vision, and mission. Purpose is the why you exist, the big reason for being, for a brand or business that is not just about making a profit or driving shareholder value. Vision is where you want to get to. This is the destination of what you want the brand or business to be in the future. Missions are the what you should do to get there. These could be specific initiatives or tactics centered around product development, operational excellence, go-to-market strategies, or brand communications. A sentence that brings this to life is, one purpose, many missions. Values are the how you would like to behave in order to get there. What is the organizational culture of a company or an organization? And what are the qualities or behavior it prizes? For instance, curiosity, inclusivity, diversity of thought, and so on. Knowing the deeper why your company or brand exists provides the foundation on which to build everything else. Your how, organizational culture, brand experience, and your what products or services you offer. One story that illustrates the power of purpose is that of President John F. Kennedy, who was walking around NASA in 1962 and saw a janitor carrying a broom. When he asked the man what he did, Well, Mr. President, the janitor responded, I'm helping put a man on the moon. It showed how the purpose of NASA had powerfully spread to every single person within the organization. A few other examples that is worth mentioning: Starbucks, our mission to inspire and nurture the human spirit, one person, one cup, and one neighborhood at a time. And Zappos, delivering happiness. Tesla founder Elon Musk himself explains the power of purpose like this. Putting in long hours for a corporation is hard. Putting in long hours for a cause is easy. So how do you bring purpose to life? The first and most important way is through company culture. If your employees do not believe in and live the purpose every day, no amount of fancy marketing taglines or slogan can even help. Remember, culture is the first product of any business. So to sum this up, we are moving to a new era where purpose-driven brands will be in the best position to attract the right talent, drive their brand and business, and do a tremendous amount of good in the world. This purpose-driven approach works in every single category in every single country around the world. Marketers who embrace this shift will find a deeper level of meaningfulness in their work and see the potential to genuinely add value to the lives of their customer. Okay, that's all for this 5-Minute Friday. I appreciate you giving me your attention and time. If you like this video, please consider giving it a good thumbs up and hit that subscribe button while you're at it. It actually makes a difference. I do hope you found this session interesting and that I managed to ignite a tiny spark of curiosity with my knowledge and insight. Next week, we'll talk about, we all have a story, what is yours? Until then, be safe, stay awesome, and I'll see you next Friday.